for being here tonight. I'm really impressed to see such a large crowd for it's just orchestra, so that's really cool. And it's a stormy night, so that's especially nice to see so many people here. Great audience. That first piece you heard, the hornpipe, was one of the pieces we played for UIL concert and sight reading contest with the advanced orchestra. I hope that was a chair. Something out of wood other than an instrument. But that was the first one of the pieces we played. The next two pieces you're going to hear, and that was with our Academy Orchestra, the Advanced Orchestra. Now on stage we have all of the middle school students, our entire group, are all the Academy, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. And we're going to play another one of the pieces that they did for contest called Star Dancer, and then Stone Mountain Stomp. And both of those pieces, all of these students on stage played at the Sandy Lake competition. So in just to, since we're on that subject right now, talking about contests, we're really really excited about how they did at UIL this year for the second time in the history of our school, as far as we part I know. The orchestra has made sweepstakes, which means they made a first division in concert, the first division in sight reading, and that's what this plaque is over here for that group. So I'm really excited about that happening for the second time. And I did bring in both of the trophies, but both the middle school orchestra went to the competition, which we just talked about, they're going to play, and also our elementary group, our fifth grade group, went to play, and they both got trophies of it. It's exactly like that one, except that one of them got damaged, but we didn't. That isn't why we didn't bring it. I didn't bring it in here, though. But they both look like that, and I'm really excited about our fifth grade group getting a first division, a straight first division from all the judges at Sandy Lake, as well as middle school. I'm going to try to get most of this talking stuff over with right now so we can just get on playing music, because as you can see, we have quite a bit since our last concert to deal with and to play. I kept the same notations for what organizations the students qualified for back in the fall. I haven't updated it with things like solo and ensemble, so I may go along with that in a minute. You'll have to refresh my memory because it's very short, but it's who all did first divisions and got went on solo and ensemble and that kind of thing. We had students that made all-region orchestra, students that made all-region symphonic orchestra, concert orchestra, some made all-city, and those are notated on here on the program there. And later on, I think we'll have them stand and be recognized for that too, but I just want to mention that right now. But you might be wondering about the title of the program, it's Plugged and Unplugged. Well, we're going to use a guitar, so that's one plug. Okay, that's it. Except for the microphones, and we're using microphones for some of the pieces. Not on that first piece you heard, that was all acoustic. And I want to introduce a drummer at this time, Kevin Woods from Brian Adams came over. He volunteered his services, come over and play for us, and we're excited. And he's going to play on some of the pieces you see there. And in those case, in that case, we need microphones and we need to be plugged in. So Kevin totally wipes out with his drum set. So our next piece is Star Dancer, and we'll check tuning real quick and go on.
I
thought this wasn't going to be a two-hour concert. All right, this is a bit as many string instruments as you've ever tried to put on stage, and I don't even know what it is anymore. I want to mention this is all of our fifth grade students, beginner students, which is normally 14, but we have 13 tonight. And then our 22 of our middle school, but they are combined. And then we also have a few guests that I want to make sure I mention, because I didn't put them on the program. I feel a little bad, but I wasn't really sure, because some of them have been on a trip all last week for their school. These are students from Lakewood, and they combined, and I did mention that a minute ago, they combined with our fifth grade. No rehearsal, just went to the contest together, and 10 students from Lakewood combined with our 14 students from Travis for that trophy that I was telling you about at Sandy Lake. So I want to make sure these guys get recognized, but I invited them to come play on our concert. On cello, and John Delanitas on violin. And as I understand, a number of the other ones would have come tonight too. One or two, but they had a tag event, which I understand is kind of an important thing. At Lakewood, so they had to do that, and I know they couldn't be here, but. I just appreciate these three coming along, and wish the others could too. We have six cellos over there, so I was hoping that all of them could be here. We have a huge cello section. Cello party or something. So this is Ode to Joy, and you'll hear the melody in the violins and violas, then you hear the melody in the cellos and basses, and then you get to hear it one more time on the violins and the violas. Here we go. So we do it over and over, we get to the point where we're almost sick of it. So I thought, well, you know, but it is a good piece, so maybe what we ought to do is just do it a little bit differently. So we kind of combined some other pieces. I put together an arrangement, thought drum part would be really cool with this, so we got Kevin here helping us out on that. So this is Fur Jaca with drums and everything, okay?
Thank you. And been working on it perfectly, amazing.
I
They're enjoying having this kind of, be able to play other types of music, and we start to see more and more of that. There's a lot of musicians that are promoting electrified strings. You're seeing orchestras and all different places and string players. So it's kind of neat, which is good for string players, especially ones that want to be professional, because it just gives them another thing that can make money doing. So this is trying to introduce them to that idea that there are other ways to play. Do things with your instrument, play in all different kinds of groups. So, the next one we're going to do, the idea for this came from actually Noah on the camp that he went to, that one of the directors there arranged a version of Smooth Criminal, which was kind of loosely based on a YouTube sensation, a group of two guys called Two Cellos. And if you Google them, they're great. They're really good. They play a lot of rock music from Eastern Europe. And it was based on that. And then I expanded it so we could play with the whole orchestra and throw in drums and so forth and things too. And also another thing about this that's a little different than any we've ever tried to do before. We're opening this up to a solo, so Noah's gonna take a solo, and it's improv. He made it up. I didn't write it down for him. He's making it up as he goes on that. And Dalton Wolf is gonna do that on Tuesday Face back here too, so we're gonna do solos for them. But before we finish, I just want to say thank you for supporting your students. At a PTA concert earlier in the year in Lakewood, I spent some time talking about how some recent studies have shown that, and surveys have shown that professional musicians, to reach that, is their status as a professional player. It's been shown that about a 10,000 hour of practice is what it's taken to reach that level. And I think what's important about that is that that really applies even to the stages in between. To continue to improve just simply requires time and help. So I appreciate you supporting them and their practice. Regular practice means much more than just a lot of practice all at one time, every once in a while. It's good for them to establish that habit of doing that every day, and I appreciate you helping them with that. But the 10,000 hour thing, you hear me say it a lot, talk about it, because it's pretty much true for many other things as well, not just playing an instrument, but acquiring professional level experience in any other area too. So that's quite an investment. We did the numbers on that, figured out what that's about. If you're gonna do that, that would be roughly 4 hours a day, every day, for 6.5 years or so, something like that. So that's a pretty serious commitment, and I'd like to thank our eighth graders. In fact, I'd like for them to stand and be recognized, all the eighth grade students. Sticking with orchestra and staying with it and being devoted to it, and they're all really good. I'm really excited about them. To hear about big things about them in the future, I've been fortunate to hear about former Travis students going on to Booker T and other schools and making the all-city orchestra, making all-region orchestra, whether they're there or at another school, and I love seeing them all again. So I'm looking forward to seeing these guys again down the line at events like that. So I think we're good to go here. Oh, thanks. What number did you get? 3, 4. I suggest they do that at the last minute. Nolan and Rebecca will have a fight.
No.